We are on the brink of a new era of work, where artificial intelligence works together with humans in a hybrid workforce. And this is a fundamental shift that's happening right now, and it's going to change the future of work in some interesting ways. So when the pandemic hit, a lot of people had to start working from home. And sometimes entire customer service departments were out of commission due to having, obviously, sick employees. And businesses needed a quick solution to these problems as their waiting lines got bigger and bigger. So some of these businesses, they turned to AI, and they found out some very interesting results. So they found out that besides reducing or even completely eliminating waiting lines at customer service, they were also able to resolve issues about 3 to 5 times faster than human agents. They got 20% higher customer satisfaction and NPS scores than their human colleagues, and they also improved the productivity of the human colleagues. Now, this is just an example from customer service, but let's take a step back and look more broadly at AI-based employees. Just imagine being able to hire an employee that works 24/7, never needs a break, never loses focus, can speak more than 100 languages fluently, is an expert in automation, and also automatically publishes data analysis about its work with suggestions for improvement, and can speak with more than 2,000 people simultaneously. So these employees already exist, and they're based on AI. And with these types of results and possibilities, you'd think that business leaders are jumping to adopt AI into the organization. But actually, a lot of businesses were hesitant to adopt AI employees. I think some of the challenges towards adoption came from the fact that some of the earlier forms of AI, decision tree algorithms, were limited to binary choices and simple rule-based decision making. They lacked the ability to reason about the relationships between different entities, which reduced their overall performance and accuracy. And most business leaders' experiences with AI are based on these old decision tree structures. And this set back the reputation of AI assistants as a flexible and scalable technology. But with the evolution of knowledge graphs and AI in general, AI systems have been able to overcome these limitations. So a knowledge graph, as you can see over here, represents a network of real-world entities, different objects, events, or concepts, and illustrates the relationship between them. So they offer the possibility to quickly and dynamically create new links between information, and this helps to provide a more flexible and scalable way to process information and knowledge. Unlike earlier decision tree systems, knowledge graphs allow for a more dynamic conversation and understanding about different subjects. Another important challenge was the time and expertise needed to develop and deploy and manage AI. So Andrew Ng had a recent TED talk where he talked about the fact that in medieval times, reading and writing was only available for people of high status or priests. And the rest of the population, they couldn't really read or write. And in the same way, AI has been limited to large companies with the necessary budgets or expertise to apply these and maintain these solutions. And now I'm going to talk a little bit about why the new technologies can help with solving some of these challenges. So AI is only as helpful as the underlying knowledge it has access to. With all decision tree-based systems, which most virtual assistants are still based on today, the underlying knowledge is not great, and therefore the value also wasn't great. But we've come a long way since then with advancements in neural networks and long-term, short-term memory networks. And training these machine learning models is kind of like having a library where you have to bring in the books on different topics that you wanted to understand. And the AI will then go back and look for the information based on the books that they have available. But now large language models have come. And a large language model is kind of like having a library with tens of thousands of books about all these different subjects, and which is great because it has a general understanding of everything. And this improves the underlying knowledge that AI systems have access to, and if we allow AI systems to leverage these large language models, it will also massively speed up the development for artificial intelligence-based employees. Because of the changing environment created by hybrid working, companies started to adopt new technologies to help assist their employees. And in the future, I think more and more interactions that consumers will have with businesses will be with AI. And in hybrid workforces, AI will handle all the repetitive and time-consuming tasks, freeing up humans to focus on more complex and value-adding tasks. So what does the future of AI look like? Well, I believe that in the future, AI will be integrated into every aspect of our lives. And for just about anything, we will have an artificial intelligence-based assistant that can help us solve problems, give us recommendations, and even execute tasks for us. So if we look at healthcare, AI-powered health assistants can help diagnose different diseases, which free up a lot of time for doctors to handle more complex cases. In finance, if you have any questions about investments or maybe retirement planning, you simply refer to your artificial intelligence-based investment banker. And in education, artificial intelligence-powered teachers will help students that maybe don't have the necessary finances for a good education to explain concepts and all these beautiful different types of things. So I think that we are on the brink of a new era where if we look at how the internet decentralized information for everyone, now advanced AI will be able to decentralize knowledge and give people access to this. So this was my talk. Thank you very much for your time.